Hello, my dear students. Welcome to Food Mechanics lecture series. This is the first session on Food Mechanics. Food Mechanics is also called Mechanics of Fluid. What is Mechanics? Mechanics is a branch of science which mainly dealing with the bodies under rest or in motion due to the action of the forces. Now, in Fluid Mechanics, we are going to discuss about the behavior of the fluid under rest or in motion due to the action of the forces. Before going to the details of fluid mechanics, we are going to introduce what is fluid. So the definition of the fluid start from the discussion on substance or matter, which can be distinguished by the physical form of its existence. These forms are known as phases. We have the solid phase, liquid phase, and gaseous phase. So substance or matter, which is composed of molecules or respective substances. Since molecules are existing, molecular forces are also present. Molecular forces are two types. One is Cauchy force and other is adhesive force. Cauchy force means it is the force of attraction between similar type of molecules. Whereas adhesive force means it is a force of attraction between the different type of molecules. For example, if you are considering water in a glass. So the force of attraction between the water molecules is called Cauchy force. Whereas the force of attraction between the water molecules and the walls of the glass, that is called adhesive force. Substance can be divided into two types, that is solid and fluid. Cauchy forces are very high in solid, so that makes molecules are rigid and they are very closely packed, so that it will give you proper shape to the solid. So because of this proper shape and the molecules are very rigid and these molecules are very closely packed, then the solid can resist compressive, tensile and shear force. Behavior of the solid can be better explained with an example. So let us consider a solid. So this solid is subjected to a force at the top. So we are applying a tangential force at the top edge. So the bottom side is fixed. So when we are applying this force at the top edge, these two edges are moving towards this side, that is in the direction of the force. If we are stressing this body within the elastic limit, once this force is removed, what happened is it will be rebound to the original shape, or the stress developed is proportional to d theta. So if you are applying this force for a long time, then there is no change for this deformation. Even if you are removing this force, then this body will be retains its original shape after the removal of the force if you are stressing this body within the elastic limit. However, this fluid is a substance which is capable of flowing, and fluid is divided into liquid and gas. So in both liquids and gas, there are many common characteristics. That is why this both liquids and gas are coming under this term fluid. Regarding the forces, we can apply this compressive force for the liquid and gas. Both liquids and gas are compressible, but regarding the shear force, cannot resist the shear force. So this can be explained by keeping the liquid between the two plates. One side is fixed and other side is moving. Now we are applying a force at the top edge. Plate is moving because of this force here. Now consider a section here. Okay, so after some time delta t, this position liquid section is moving towards this side, and for the next delta t it is moving to this portion, and this is continuing. So as long as we are applying this shear force means it's a tangential force, so that means fluid is deforming continuously, so it cannot resist the shear force. So this force, if you are applying for a long time, then the fluid is keep on deforming. So to conclude, we can say in solid, shear stress is proportional to strain when it is stressed within the elastic limit, or F by A is proportional to d theta. Whereas in fluid, what happened is shear stress is proportional to rate of strain, or F by A is proportional to d theta by dt. So this behavior of this fluid can be better explained by considering the atomic nature of solid, liquid and gas. So in solids, or we have discussed that Cauchy forces are very high, so the molecules are rigid and they are very closely packed in a definite pattern, and this pattern is repeating. So this can give proper shape to the solid body, and its volume is also fixed. Whereas in liquid, molecular spaces are available. Now compared to solid, Cauchy forces are less for a liquid. And since spaces are available between the molecules, these molecules are not rigid. It can rotate or it can translate. So some relative motion is possible for a liquid is concerned. So that is why it's not rigid, and this movement is possible. It does not have a fixed shape, but it is having a fixed volume. So this can be explained by pouring liquid to a glass. So if you are pouring the liquid to a glass, it will be occupy the shape of the glass. but it is maintaining some free surface. If you are stopping the flow, then there will be a free surface at the top. Now, if you are transferring the liquid from this glass to a bottle, what will happen is it will be occupy the shape of the bottle. So again, the volume is constant, but it is having some free surface at the top. So as far as liquid is concerned, molecules are not rigid and no fixed shape, but the volume is constant and it is maintaining some free surface at the top. Now comes to the gases. In gas, molecules are widely spaced and Cauchy forces are very less compared to liquid. So they are not rigid and no fixed shape and no fixed volume. So if you are changing the gas from one container to another container, what happens is it will be expanding up to the top of the container. So that means for a gas is concerned, they are not rigid, there is no fixed shape and there is no fixed volume. And the major difference for the liquid and gas is, though they are having similar properties, liquid is having free surface but gas does not have. And another thing is, liquid is having fixed volume whereas gas does not have the fixed volume. If you are removing the lid of the container, what happened is the complete gas that is going out. So for a gas is concerned, volume of the gas that is equal to the volume of the container. So to conclude the properties of this fluid, we can say that fluid is a substance which is capable of flowing and it cannot withstand the shear forces and it is continuously deforming as soon as shear forces are applied. Or in fluids, we can say shear stress is proportional to rate of strain. Then another approach for a fluid is concerned, that is continuum approach. So continuum approach is better explained by considering the atomic nature of solid, liquid and gas. So in solids, there is no space is available, whereas in liquid and gas, space between molecules are available. So though fluid properties basically depends upon the atomic nature, in engineering applications, we are considering the bulk behavior of the fluid. That means we are not considering the molecular level difference. That means the space between the molecules are not considered, and if you are comparing the total size of the system. So in fluid is considered as continuous distribution of matter without any void and space. That means properties are considering the point functions, because the distance between the molecules are very small compared to the size of the system we are considering. So in engineering or in practical fluid, we are considering the bulk behavior or density, and that will be equal to density of the liquid that is containing in this glass. That means we are defining fluid is the continuous distribution of matter without any void and space. So that is called continuum. So because of that, there is no discontinuity in the property, because we are not considering the molecular level variation. Continuum approach is a hypothetical concept. So continuum approach make it possible to deal the fluid on macroscopic scale and define a statistical average property for the fluid. So to conclude, we can say that fluid properties are continuous and homogeneous. So there is no discontinuity in the fluid property with respect to the space between the molecules. To conclude, substance divided into solid and fluid. In solids, Cauchy forces are very high, whereas fluids, it is less. Now, fluid cannot withstand shear forces. That is one of the major differences. Difference between the liquid and gas is, liquid is having some fixed volume and it's having free surface, but gas does not have the fixed volume. And both the liquids and gas does not have any shape. It can occupy the shape of the container. Regarding the forces, the solid can resist the shear force. In solids, shear stress is proportional to strain, whereas in fluids, shear stress is proportional to the strain rate. The last one is continuum approach. Continuity approach is a hypothetical approach. So because of that, we can assume the fluid properties as continuous. That means we are not worried about the space between the molecules. We are considering the bulk behavior of the fluid in engineering applications. In other words, the space between the molecules are negligible compared to the size of the system what we are considering. Or fluid properties are considered as the point function. So that approach is called continuum approach. So here fluid is treated as continuum. So this continuum approach, fluid properties are continuous, homogeneous, no discontinuity with respect to the atomic structure. So with that, for the time being, it is enough. Thank you. Awaiting your comments.